So I'm going to cover the Fire Standard Brick Company in Pueblo, Colorado, and I'm going to show you guys the crazy build of all of this and to really think about how much time it actually takes to build buildings and stuff, and to go from nowhere in the middle of the desert to lay out all of this in record time within 30 years from becoming a one-horse town to 1900. Okay, so I've taken you in and I've shown you different things of the grand scale of this and what you really have to comprehend, but to put everybody into perspective, because I don't have any pictures of the Standard Fire Brick Company, I only have blueprints of the layout of it, and those are in the Sunborn Fire Insurance maps. Now, I believe that those maps are actually used for something else, and I believe that they were the layout for to keep track of the city of how they developed and stuff back in the day. Because they're well detailed and they're actually laid out within scale, which is pretty phenomenal, being that a city basically with all these different migrant workers coming in from all over the world, and we're able to cohesive with each other and to build a city like this. And so let's just really give this into perspective of what I'm talking about. So this is Union Street. Now, this is one of the earlier pictures I could find of Union Street. Now, this is looking northbound on Union Street, basically. Well, you'd be looking northeast. But this right here shows Pueblo in the background. And this tree was cut down in 1883. And they go from that to basically, well, let me show you, to this, which was probably taken before the flood in 50 years, and built all of these massive stone buildings from going from a one horse town. Now, that tree was cut down somewhere down here, and let's draw it out so you guys can see where that tree was. That tree had to been clear down here. So in 1883, they cut it down, and this is what you magically build in the middle of the night. Now, a lot of these stone buildings you have to look at, and you have to look at all of the detail into it. So when they're laying this out, all the masons had to be skilled labor in order to be able to put this kind of architect together, or this building together, to make these beautiful stone buildings in brick. And you can see in this one, and I don't know if that is that one weird photograph where it has like the dome on it, which they've taken a lot of these, and they've defaced these buildings to basically hide up the history. So let's go down and give you guys what I'm talking about, the brick fire plant. So we're gonna go up here, and you have to remember these are all city blocks that they built all in record time. So the Fire Standard Brick Company is clear up here. Okay, so if you go into my drives into Pueblo and you go down here, we'll go to the bottom, and I have the Standard Fire Brick Company in here. Standard Fire Brick Company. And this is what I was able to collect was these maps, because they are the only things that I could find that showed the layout of the fire brick plant. And you can see that this is a huge operation. It takes up three city blocks, if not four. And so in 1891 this plant opened. So basically in 1889 they were building this. And when a lot of this stuff you look up, and there are dates and they do give details on the building, there are these massive stone structures that were just magically built within a year with no power equipment, no transportation other than horse and wagon in order to get to the site. And so what you have to understand is when they're building a city, like, they have to lay out all the streets and everything and then put in the sewers and the water lines and the electrical lines all in one shot. And so these guys magically did it. And so you go into, I believe it's this one. So this is where I actually found it at, and this is a map of 1905 or 1904. This one's the 1904, and then the south side when they did that was 1905. And these were the last maps that were ever made by Sunborn that I can find on here, because they show these two maps going all the way up to 1950, and you can see the progression of what they basically blueprinted or redlined on it, actually redlined. And so you go into this and you could see the massive scope of all of this that was built. Now, these smelting plants right here are these foundry plants. I want to give you guys an idea of where they're at. Okay, so if we zoom back out to Standard Fire Brick Company and we go down and we zoom in right here, and those are those two plants right there next to this huge smelting plant. So they built all of this stuff in record time. And so, like I said, the more and more I keep showing you guys, like, this was all built just within record time, all of this. I mean you can't imagine the amount of work that went into this at a time when they didn't have plows or skidsters or front-end loaders or any of that heavy equipment in order to move this stuff. And so either they had technology that they're not telling us and that they built in record time, and we are where we're at is just what we've created. But that's it. If you critically think about this and think what it takes to build cities and to keep going, I mean, we've had examples of this since we've been collecting information through the history since all of this started. In the last 50-100 years, we've shown, like, the progression of cities. They just don't magically just explode into like 20,000 people in the middle of the night. And we have a mass immigration coming in now as a prime example. These guys are flooding into the country. They don't have any skilled trades to bring with them. So how is it you think 120 years ago, 130 years ago, they had all these people flow into the United States with all these skilled trades? So I don't know, maybe it was a reset at one time and somehow we lost our memory to know what is really happening to us, but there is something definitely fishy. And I'll go through everything. I mean, City Park, Mineral Palace, I mean, it just keeps growing, the list, and this record time of all of this stuff they built. And I'll go into CF&I and I'll show you where they added to this plant, where it's just this absolute largest steel mill east of the Mississippi. So how did they accomplish all of this? Where did they get the steel, the engineers, and everybody to figure this out, to put this together, and to build this? And the way Pueblo is set up, it was absolutely perfect for what they did. I mean, you hit the smelting plants in the train line. I mean, you couldn't have asked for a better setup for this. And yet a bunch of cowboys in 1870 thought about this and drew all this out so that way they had it for when they built it. I mean, you can't, I mean, it's just, it's impossible when you're looking at it. So that's then this one. I'll keep going through them and try to point all this out, but it's absolutely, it takes a while to get your mind around it, to realize that our history is a lie.